We're digging it.
We started to realize we had some really good stuff.
So we went and took the next step.
You know, and then we started looking for a home for it and found Virgin EMI, and here we are. Here we go.
It was just a question of just our friendship and, you know, saying goodbye to Lance Daly, which is probably a process that will never end for the three of us, you know, but...
The album title comes from the song Black Gives Way to Blue.
A pretty heavy tune. It was a really beautiful song that Jerry wrote for Lane.
I mean, although we dealt with all of that privately and are continuing to do so, the reality of Lane dying and the reality of what do you do with the rest of your life, you know? And I kind of put that into a song, and I guess that was the first time that I kind of said it out loud, you know? And I got really fucking sick. I got really ill.
Like these crazy migraines. I went to all these doctors. I even had a spinal tap trying to figure out what was wrong with him, and there was nothing wrong with him.
Yeah, it turned out to be some sort of a migraine episode, I guess, that lasted for about 3 weeks. I think what it was basically coughing up a big chunk of grief, I guess, that I undigested grief that I hadn't processed yet.
When we were tracking that song, Jerry was singing it, and it was me and him and Nick in the studio, and it was just heavy, like a really heavy thing. It was kind of, we kept putting it off. The music was done, we kept putting that song off because we knew it was going to be pretty heavy. And when he was singing it, he was having a hard time. And I had like an anxiety attack. I remember I went up in the bathroom and like sat on the floor there and barely breathed, put water on my face. But it was a really, really special moment, you know, because it was such a heavy thing for us.
Those are the kinds of experiences that really forged some pretty deep bonds, I think.
And then we were thinking, you know, maybe putting some piano on it, and our buddy the Baldy was in there, and he said, you know, call Elton. We're like, yeah, right, you know, that's not gonna, sure.
And I just thought that was a crazy idea. I love Elton John, and he's pretty much like the inspiration for me to become a musician. So I wrote him a little note and sent it to him, emailed him, and kind of explained what the song was about, and he said he would do it. Every album experience is completely different, like every album should be, I think. And music kind of reflects where you are at the time, I guess. And it's a lot of years had passed, and we lost a really good friend and partner in Lane, someone we loved dearly and depended on as a very important member of the band. You know, a lot of the earlier records, Facelift, you know, I mean, God, we were just a bunch of wild kids, man. But this, you know, this record, obviously, there was so many challenges to overcome. You know, everybody really came to the plate. We busted our asses on this record. We put everything we had into it. And I'm really, really happy and pleased with the results.
Basically, I think the central theme about the whole record is us just kind of going through this together and, you know, saying goodbye to our friend and brother and just really special process for me to do this with family as opposed to, you know, just some dudes that play instruments. You know, it's so much more to this thing than you know, that stuff. And just still feels right and, you know, came together. Oh, excuse me.
We all were finding that, you know, it still meant the world to us to play music. Music continues to be the thing that is there for me. Kind of evolving, I guess, evolving into what we could be now, and not dishonoring what had gone on before. I just really enjoy being a part of this band. I always have. And you know, without getting too like flowery and metaphysical about it, it just feels like shit's right.